Hello everyone. In this session, I'm going to discuss on virtualization in cloud computing. So these are all the contents or topics which comes under virtualization. So guys, what is virtualization? Okay, in general, virtualization means which is not real, that is which is not actual. So in computing, virtualization refers to an act of creating something virtual rather than actual version of something else. So this virtualization is a framework or methodology of dividing the resources of a computer into multiple execution environments. By how? By applying one or more technologies like your hardware and software partitioning, by time sharing, by making the machine partial or complete, and by emulating, that is reproducing and making the quality of services. So there is another definition. It is the enabling technology and creates virtual machines that allows a single machine to act as if it were many machines. See, in traditional systems, an individual applications were running on individual machines. So thus, it is expensive. So by virtualization, it provides a solution to this issue. So why this virtualization is cost effective and makes the resources sharing efficiency. And next, this virtualization has some physical characteristics of computer resources like your applications or end users. It also includes making a single physical resource to appear and to function as multiple virtual resources. So here, vice versa. So this virtualization, it can also include making multiple physical resources to appear as a single virtual resource. And next comes, why virtualization? So guys, why we need this virtualization? So we need virtualization to consolidate the workloads of underutilized servers to fewer machines. See, consolidate means merging or integrating all the workloads which is underutilized servers to fewer machine. So this fewer machine may be a single machine. And this virtualization provides some securities and isolated sandboxes for running an untrusted application. See here, what is this isolated sandboxes? It's an isolate testing environment that enables users to run programs without affecting the applications. Okay? And it provides some hardware configurations, and this virtualization is used to simulate networks of independent computers, and it allows powerful debugging. So what is debugging? Identifying and removing the errors, right? So, and it also performs some monitoring. So by doing this, your operating system is debugged without losing its productivity. Yes? Okay. These virtual machines are great tools for doing any research and any exploratory academic experiments. And this enables existing operating system to run on shared memory multiprocessors. That is a computer. This shared memory into multiprocessors is a computer system composed of multiple independent processors that executes different instruction streams. And it can be used to create arbitrary test scenarios. So here arbitrary means an absolute test scenarios. By doing this, we can lead to effective quality assurance. And next, role of virtualization. So this virtualization plays a major role, but it also provides some virtual storages and computing services to the cloud clients. So who is cloud clients here? Your computers, your phones, other devices like OS, that is operating systems, and your browsers. So this virtualization contains some, that is includes some things like protection from system failures. If at all there is a system failure, this virtualization protects our data. That is, by making the data duplicate on the cloud by using virtualization, the data is safe. Yes? And it virtualization, it improves the performance and capacity, like storage capacity, network capacity, server capacity. Yes, okay. And it is used for grouping physical storage devices into the single unit. So it is used for combining the physical storage devices into the single module. And it is also used for reaching the high level of availability resources. And this virtualization helps IT professionals become efficient and agile at work. So this helps the IT professionals to be at their workplace efficiently, and agile means gracefully, intellectually, smartness at their workplace. And the great role or way in virtualization is to reduce operational cost. So guys, what is this operational cost here? So this is the cost of resources used by an organization, okay? And next comes your benefits, advantages and disadvantages. So there are some benefits, like it reduces your capital expenses and it reduces your maintenance cost through server consolidation, that is by merging all the servers, and it reduces physical space which is needed to the data centers. And some of other benefits like resource management, migration, that is resettling, maintainability, high availability and fault tolerance. So these are all the benefits in the virtualization. So next is advantages. So first one is it optimizes the hardware resource utilization. So it optimizes means it makes the best or most effective resource utilization. And it makes possible to run multiple applications and various operating systems on the same server at the same time. By making this, we will save our energy and our cost, right? So, and it increases the utilization, efficiency and flexibility, and it manages your resources effectively by reliability, right? Okay. And it also increases efficiency of IT operations. So guys, what is this IT operations here? So your IT management, service management, technical management, application management. Yes, this all comes under this IT operations. And this also provides easier backup. That is, if at all you want your backup system, so this is the easiest way to get your backup system. And disaster recovery, there is a quick recovery in virtualization. And it increases cost savings with reduced hardware expenditure. So next comes your disadvantages. So the disadvantages of virtualization are negligible. Why? When compared to all these multiple advantages which is offered by virtualization, these two can be neglected. That is software licensing cost. What is licensing cost here? The amount or cost paid by an individual or organization to a government agency for the privilege of performing a certain service of that particular software you are using. And there is a necessity to train the IT staff, that is employees, if they are using virtualization in their organization. So these are all the benefits, advantages and disadvantages. And next comes your virtual machine monitor. So here, virtual machine monitor is a software program that enables the creation, management and governance of virtual machine. So guys, what is this virtual machine here? Well, this virtual machine is a method of achieving your virtualization. So this virtual machine is used to achieve your virtualization. This is created by whom? This software program, that is virtual machine monitor. It also manages the operation of virtualized environment on top of physical host machine, that is on your physical server. So virtual machine is also known as, these virtual machines are software based computers that have their own operating systems and applications, and this virtual machine is completely independent of one another. So these virtual machines are created by this software to achieve the virtualization. So you see, this VMM, is known as virtual machine manager or hypervisor. This is also known as hypervisor. Hypervisor or VMM, that is virtual machine monitor, is a computer software, a firmware, or hardware. So this hypervisor can be a hardware or software or any firmware. This create what? This creates and creates virtual machines and runs this virtual machines. A computer, that is a hypervisor which is running on the computer, that hypervisor runs one or more virtual machines. Those machines is called host machine or host operating system. But whereas this virtual machine is itself a guest machine, that is a hypervisor which is running on the computer, that hypervisor runs one or more virtual machines. Those machines are called host machines or host operating system. And each virtual machine which is running on the hypervisor is itself a guest machine or guest operating system. And these are the some examples of this hypervisor, that is VMware Fusion, Oracle VirtualBox, Oracle VM for x86, and Solidus Zones, Parallels, and VMware Workstation. And next comes the two types of hypervisor. First type is, it's called as bare metal hypervisor, and second type is host metal hypervisor. So in type 1 hypervisor, it is referred to as bare metal hypervisor. This means it runs directly on the physical hardware of the host machine. It doesn't have to load an underlying operating system before that. See, here there is a difference between type 1 and type 2. Here there is no underlying operating system. Here there is an underlying operating system. So in the type 2, it is typically installed on an hosted hypervisor installed on an existing operating system. This makes it a hosted hypervisor, seeing as it relies on the host machine OS to undertake certain operations like managing calls, that is your hardware calls, to the CPU, and it manages the network resources, and it manages the memory and storage devices. So these are the two types of hypervisors, hyper 1, hyper 2, that is bare metal hypervisor, host based hypervisor. And these are the examples of type 1, that is Microsoft Hyper-V, VMware ESXi, Citrix Zen Server, and these examples are of type 2, that is VMware Fusion, Oracle VirtualBox, Oracle VM for x86, Solidus Zones, Parallels, and VMware Workstation. These are the two types of hypervisors. And next comes types of virtualization. So there are many types of virtualization. First is your full line para virtualization. This is full virtualization and this is para virtualization. So here there is a main difference between these two virtualization. The full virtualization allows multiple operating systems to execute on a host operating system independently, whereas this para virtualization allows multiple guest operating system to run on host operating system while communicating with the hypervisor. This full virtualization, it doesn't communicate with hypervisor. This para virtualization, it communicates with the hypervisor. And there are some of the differences between full virtualization and para virtualization. There is a difference between definition also. By definition, we can difference this full virtualization and para virtualization. Functionality, the main difference is the full virtualization allows guest operating system to execute independently, while this para virtualization allows guest operating systems to communicate with the hypervisor directly. By accessing hardware, this full virtualization gets some issues or calls, that is hardware calls, to access the hardware. And para virtualization it directly communicates with the hypervisor using some drivers. And according to the performance is higher in para-virtualization than in full virtualization. And next type is server virtualization. So server virtualization is a partition of physical servers into multiple virtual servers. So this server virtualization, it involves in partitioning a physical server into a number of small virtual servers with the help of virtualization software. So here each virtual server is running its own operating system and its own applications on the virtual services. So this decision is done to improve the utility of server resources. And there are some benefits of server virtualization. One is economical, that is inexpensive, low cost or low price, and quick deployment and provisioning, that is the action of bringing all the resources into effective action. And disaster recovery, a quick recovery, right? And increased productivity, increasing the productivity and availability. Yes? Okay, this is the server virtualization. This is your physical host server partitioned into several virtual machines. And on the virtual machines, there are different OSs and applications running on it by using virtualization software. And next comes network virtualization. So this network virtualization, it is a method of combining all the available resources in a network to consolidate multiple physical networks. It divides a network into segments or to create software networks between these virtual machines. So this network virtualization refers to the management and monitoring of a computer network as a single managerial entity to form a single software based on whom administrator's console, that is services console. And by using this network virtualization, it is useful for networks that experiences a huge or rapid or unpredictable traffic increases. So there are two categories of network virtualization. One is internal and another is external. So both of these terms refers to inside or outside the server. So internal network virtualization, it provides some network-like functionality to a single system, that is single network server, whereas external, it combines some networks or parts of the networks into a virtual unit. These parts can be your switches, adapters, CF, your switches, adapters, or your networks, LANs, and more networks into virtual units. And next comes lastly, that is your storage virtualization. This storage virtualization, it's a process of grouping the physical storage from multiple network storage devices so that it looks like a single storage device. So in the figure or in the diagram, there are two servers with the virtual volumes. These virtual volumes may be mapped or directed to the different applications. So between this actual storage, that is physical storage, and the virtual volumes, there is a virtualization layer which helps in redirecting your inputs and outputs. So it is the process of representing the physical storage in the logical form to any server. And it provides some advantages like storage management, easy updates, better availability, and it reduces some downtime, and it gives the better storage utilization, and it have the automated management. Yes, and there are two types of storage virtualization. One is block server storage virtualization and another is file storage virtualization. So this block, it replaces the controllers and takes over at the disk level, whereas this file, it should have software installed already on it, and in for what? In order to enable file level usage. Okay, these are the types of storage virtualization. Thank you.